हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू एके एंड स्प्रिंट एजुकेशन। माई सेल्फ नवीन, आई एम द मैथ्स मेंटर एंड टुडे सेशन लेट अस डिस्कस अबाउट लॉन्ग आंसर्स क्वेश्चंस, दैट इज 8 मार्क क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द चैप्टर नंबर 7, कोऑर्डिनेट ज्योमेट्री। स्टूडेंट्स, फाइंड द पॉइंट्स ऑफ ट्राइसेक्शन। वी नो दैट ट्राइसेक्शन कॉन्सेप्ट इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट 8 मार्क क्वेश्चन, नो डाउट एट ऑल। विदाउट दिस कॉन्सेप्ट असल पेपर अंत उ। फाइंड द पॉइंट्स ऑफ ट्राइसेक्शन ऑफ द लाइन सेगमेंट जॉइनिंग पॉइंट्स -2,1 एंड 7,4। आई विल ट्राई टू एक्सप्लेन, लिसन केयरफुली। पॉइंट्स ऑफ ट्राइसेक्शन, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय ट्राइसेक्शन? ट्राई नेम इटसेल्फ, ट्राई इन द सेंस थ्री, राइट? ट्राई मीन्स थ्री। आई मीन this is the line segment, this is line segment AB, line segment AB, line segment AB, the points which divides line segment into three equal parts. Suppose this is our point P and this is our point Q. The points P and Q divides line segment AB into three equal parts, right? This is one part and this is our second part and this is third part, right? So what P divides AB? So this is our AB, this is our point P. Point P divides line segment AB into the ratio, this is one part, AP is one part. What about PB? PQ is one part, QB is one part. So 1:2. P divides AB into the ratio 1:2. P divides AB into the ratio 1:2. Right? What about Q? If you observe line segment AB, this is our line segment AB and this is our point Q. Q divides AB into the ratio, see AP is one part, PQ is one part, total this is two parts. And what about QB? QB is one part. P divides AB into the ratio 1:2. And what about Q? Q divides AB into the ratio 2:1. P divides AB into the ratio 1:2. Q divides AB into the ratio 2:1. Right? So ratio, in generally we call it as m:n. Here also ratio we call it as m:n. What are the line segment joining points? As the line segment joining points are -2,1 and 7,4. So this is our x1 y1 and this is our x2 y2, right? Here we have to use section formula. What is the section formula? What is section formula? P of x comma y equal to mx2 plus nx1 by m plus n comma my2 plus ny1 by m plus n. So here we have to apply section formula. If you remember this formula, you can do it easily, trisection sum. Only thing is we need to remember section formula. Write twice or thrice so that you will remember. What is section formula? mx2 and m into x2 plus nx1, n into x1 divided by m plus n. In between, you need to write comma. See how we are opening brackets, open bracket, closed bracket. In between, we need to put comma. Right? Don't put any plus or minus sign. Here comma. Then my2 plus ny1 by m plus n. Okay, children. So now let us substitute the given points in the formula. So p of x comma y equal to m. What is the value of m? M value 1 into x2. X2 value how much? X2 value 7 plus n. N value 2 into x1 value minus 2 divided by m plus n. I mean 1 plus 2 comma my2. M value 1 into y2 value 4 plus n value 2 and y1 value 1 by 1 plus 2. So 1 7 is 7 plus into minus minus 2 to the 4 by 1 plus 2 3. 1 4 is 4 plus 2 1 is 2 by 1 plus 2 3. So 7 minus 4 3 by 3 4 plus 2 6 by 3. 3 1 is 3 1 is 3 1 is 3 2 is. So p of x comma y is 1 comma 2. Right, children? Are you feeling difficult? No. Which is the easiest if you know section formula? Practice. Easily you'll get 8 marks. Okay. Now coming to point Q. Q divides AB into the ratio 2 is to 1. The same procedure. Only thing is ratio is changing here. First of all, here ratio is 1 is to 2. But whereas here ratio is 2 is to 1. Okay. So Q divides AB into the ratio 2 is to 1. Same formula MX2. M value here 2 into x2 value 7 plus nx1 1 into x1 value minus 2 by m plus n 2 plus 1 comma my2. M is 2 into y2 value 4 plus ny1 n value 1 into y1 value 1 by m plus n, I mean 2 plus 1. 2 7 is 14 plus into minus minus 1 2 ja 2 by 3 comma 2 4 ja 8 plus 1 1 ja 1 by 3. Right? So 14 minus 2 12 by 3 comma 8 plus 1 9 by 3. 3 1 ja 3 4 ja 3 1 ja 3 3 ja. So that is 4 comma 3. Right? Therefore, what are the trisection points? Trisection points are P of 1 comma 2 and Q of 4 comma 3. So children, trisection sum is the most important sum. Most important sum. So when we are, if at all, if you see the point trisection in your question paper, then you need to remember first case ratio 1 is to 2. Second case ratio 2 is to 1. Trisection anagane mana mind lo strike avvalsindi first ratio 1 is to 2, second ratio 2 is to 1. Given points em aitai x1 y1 x2 y2. Then after that you need to remember this formula. What is the formula? P of x comma y equal to mx2 plus nx1 by m plus n comma my2 plus ny1 by m plus n. Ee three steps meeku baaga gurtundali. First thing ratio 1 is to 2, 2 is to 1. Second thing, given points are x1, y1, x2, y2. Third thing is section formula. Then we need to apply section formula 2 times so that you will get 2 points. Okay, children. After watching the video, you should pause it and then try to practice. Practice twice or thrice, you will get easily 8 marks. No doubt at all. Now coming to second one, prove that the points 5, comma 6, 11, 6, 9, 2 and 3, 2 taken in order are the corners of a parallelogram. So this method also nowadays they are asking. Okay. So which is also an easy question. Taken in order. So this is our parallelogram. So taken in order is the most important. Once if you start vertex from A here, then you need to go with B here, then C, then D. Okay? Ikkada start chesthe A, B, C, D tho povali. Here A, B, C, D, we should not place vertices like that. A, B, C, D. If you put A here, A, B, C, D. If you put A here, A, B, C, D. Order is important. So given matrices are 5, 6, 11, 6, 9, 2, 3, 2. They are the matrices of a
parallelogram.
Students, we know that diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other. What is the meaning of diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other? I mean, AC is our diagonal, line segment joining opposite vertices of a quadrilateral, BD is another diagonal. AC is one diagonal, BD is another diagonal. I mean, diagonals bisect each other meaning is midpoint of AC is equal to midpoint of BD. What is that? Midpoint of AC equal to midpoint of BD. Midpoint of AC equal to midpoint of BD. So what is midpoint formula? M of x comma y equal to x1 plus x2 by 2 comma y1 plus y2 by 2. Children, what is midpoint formula? M of x comma y equal to x1 plus x2 by 2 comma y1 plus y2 by 2. Right? So midpoint of AC. A means 5 comma 6. C means 9 comma 2. Now midpoint of BD. B means 11 comma 6. D means 3 comma 2. So we call it as x1 y1, x2 y2. Here also x1 y1, x2 y2. Okay, first let us find the midpoint of AC. X1 plus x2 by 2, I mean 5 plus 9 by 2 comma y1 plus y2 by 2, 6 plus 2 by 2 equal to. Now midpoint of BD. B is 11 plus 3, I mean x1 plus x2 by 2, 11 plus 3 by 2 comma 6 plus 2 by 2, 5 plus 9, 14 by 2, 6 plus 2, 8 by 2, 11 plus 3, 14 by 2, 6 plus 2, 8 by 2, 2 1 jar, 2 7 jar, 2 1 jar, 2 4 jar, 2 1 jar, 2 7 jar, 2 1 jar, 2 4 jar, that is 7 comma 4 equal to 7 comma 4. See, midpoint of AC must be equal to midpoint of BD. Therefore, given vertices are the corners of a parallelogram. If you get midpoint of AC is equal to midpoint of BD, then we say that they are the vertices of a parallelogram. Children, do you understand? Which is the most easy, but the thing is, ee point manaku ardham kavali. Midpoint of AC must be equal to midpoint of BD if they are the vertices of a parallelogram. Inko second point entante, midpoint formula telusundali. That is x1 plus x2 by 2 comma y1 plus y2 by 2. These two things you need to understand. First thing is, we know that diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other, meaning is midpoint of AC equal to midpoint of BD. And then we need to apply midpoint formula, both should be equal. Then we can say that they are the vertices of a parallelogram. Okay, children? Now coming to the third question, so that the points A of minus 1 comma minus 2, B of 4 comma 3, C of 2 comma 5, and D of minus 3 comma 0 in that order form a rectangle. So this is our rectangle. Vertex A minus 1 comma minus 2. B is 4 comma 3. C is 2 comma 5. D is minus 3 comma 0. We know, children, diagonals of a rectangle also bisect each other. I mean, midpoint of AC. Midpoint of AC must be equal to midpoint of BD. A and C. This is our x1, y1, x2, y2. Again, this is x1, y1, x2, y2. So x1 plus x2 by 2 minus 1 plus 2 by 2 comma y1 plus y2 by 2 minus 2 plus 5 by 2 equal to midpoint of BD 4 plus minus 3 by 2 comma 3 plus 0 by 2. Right? 2 minus 1, 1 by 2, 5 minus 2, 3 by 2 equal to 4 minus 3, 1 by 2 comma 3 plus 0, 3 by 2. See, midpoint of AC equal to midpoint of BD. They are bisect each other. Okay? And also, in a rectangle, diagonals are equal. I mean, distance between A and C must be equal to distance between B and D. Okay? Distance between A and C must be equal to AC and BD, they are equal. Diagonals are equal. Right? So, let us find distance between A and C. What is distance between two points formula? Root over x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. Right? So, AC let us find x2 is 2 minus of minus 1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. 5 minus of minus 2 whole square. That is root over. Children, are you understanding? That is distance between A and C equal to distance between B and D. Okay? Now, B and D. X2 minus X1 whole square. I mean minus 3 minus 4 whole square plus Y2 minus Y1 whole square. 0 minus 3 whole square. Right? 2 minus into minus plus 2 plus 1 3 square. 5 minus into minus plus 5 plus 2 7 square. Minus 3 minus 4 minus 7 whole square. 0 minus 3 whole square. Root gets cancelled. 3 square means 9. Plus 7 square means 49. 7 square 49, 3 square 9. That is 58 equal to 58. Okay, diagonals are equal. And also diagonals are bisect each other. I can write as diagonals are equal and bisect each other. Therefore, Hence the given points are the vertices of a rectangle. Given points are the vertices of a rectangle. Children, did you understand what we need to do here? We need to find out two things. First one is whether the diagonals are bisecting each other or not. For that, we need to apply midpoint formula. What is midpoint formula? Midpoint formula is x1 plus x2 by 2 in between comma y1 plus y2 by 2. Closed bracket, open bracket. I can say that m of x comma y. Midpoint of A and C must be equal to midpoint of B and D. The second thing, whether the diagonals are equal or not, we need to check. I mean distance between A and C must be equal to distance between B and D. What is the distance between two points formula? X2 minus X1 whole square root over plus Y2 minus Y1 whole square. Then we got distance between A and C are equal to distance between B and D. I mean diagonals are equal, also bisect each other. Hence the given points are the vertices of a parallelogram. So these are the types of questions they are asking in the public examination. After watching the video, if you do these three problems, easily you will get 8 marks. Okay? So far we have discussed section A, 16 marks. If at all any choice is there, we can go with this. Okay? And now we have two types of construction. One is construction of similar triangle, second one is construction of tangents. That I will explain so that we can complete total 4 8 j 32. So children, don't forget to hit subscribe button, like it and share it with your friends. Thank you.